Hello, welcome back to yet another episode. Today I will be taking you through the do's and don'ts of baking. For you to bake as a pro baker, you need to understand some concepts that are very important in your baking journey. So the first rule is always use a digital or mechanical weighing scale. For example, now this is what we mostly use. This is a weighing scale because you find most recipes will always ask for ingredients in terms of grams. For example, you will be asked for wheat flour, 250 grams, sugar, 200 grams, butter, 250 grams. So you need to have a weighing scale for you to get that precision. A weighing scale is very important for precision, and for your recipe and your cake to come out very well, you need precision. So this weighing scale will help you in that. Another thing, use a set of proper measuring cups where, when need be, this is the set of measuring cups. You find that, for example, this one, it's the big one is calibrated 1 cup. So when you get a recipe asking for a measuring cup, you don't use just any other cup. This is the standard measuring cups that you need. You can get them in supermarkets or in cake accessories shops. Another thing, use fresh products and locally grown ingredients. So for example, you'll be asked to use eggs, you'll be asked to use sugar, you'll be asked to use wheat flour, butter or margarine. Make sure you use what is locally available, and they should be fresh. For example, your eggs, when you're beating your eggs, make sure they are fresh. Make sure you beat each egg separately, because one spoiled egg can just ruin your whole batter. So ensure you always use fresh ingredients. Check the expiry date for you to get the correct cake, and also to ensure that your cake is of good quality and it doesn't bring any health as a hazard to the consumers. Another thing, always grease your baking tin or use a parchment paper. So the baking tin that you're using should be greased in order to ensure that your cake does not stick when you're getting it out of the baking tin, or you use a parchment paper that can serve the same purpose. So check out my previous videos, for example, baking a vanilla cake. You see how I greased my baking tins. It's very important, that step is very important. Whatever baking tin that you're using, ensure you grease it for your cake to come out well. Another thing, always sift your flour. So sometimes the flour may have like big granules, or for your cake batter to come out well, it should accumulate some air. So when you're sieving your flour, you accumulate that air, it ensures that your flour is in very fine particles for you to get the best results. Another thing, use butter at room temperature. So ensure when you're using your butter, you remove it from the oven prior so that it can be, remove your butter from the refrigerator so that it can be at room temperature by the time you're using it. So this ensures that it's easy to work with. It creams up so well and it gives you that soft, creamy feeling in your butter. And then again, it's easy to use because you can imagine that hard chilled butter, it will really give you problems. But there are special cases where you need to use chilled butter. For example, when making pies, it's always recommended that you use chilled butter. Another thing, understand your oven. There are some ovens that that require you to use 150 degrees, 180 degrees, 200 degrees. So understand your oven and know at what point do I need to set my temperature. because most recipes ask for 180 degrees, but you'll find in some ovens when you use that 180 degrees, your cake tends to burn. So I would actually advise to get an oven thermometer for you to be able to get that exact temperature that is required. So again, make sure the tin positioning in your oven is very important. In most ovens, especially the ones, the domestic cookers at home, you should place your tin at the middle. Don't and ensure that there is nothing else at the bottom or at the top. So they should be. The tin positioning is very important for your cakes to bake well. Again, understand where there are hot spots in your oven. For example, there are some, like at the back, mostly at the oven that we use, I find that at the back there or and at the corners, there is so much heat. So for my cakes to be well done, actually the middle rack does it very well. Then now, another thing that you need to do, it's only, this one I should just say it's in don'ts. There are those don'ts, there are those things I should never do when baking. For example, don't ignore the recipe and ensure availability of ingredients. So when you're told to use 250 grams of wheat flour, don't ignore and say, let me just add more so that my cake will be bigger. No, you find that you will mess up with your cake. So ensure that precision. Don't ignore the measurements that are given. Again, ensure that you have all the ingredients available. When you're baking, gather all your ingredients. For example, if a cake asks for eggs, don't replace that those eggs with water. You will not get the same results. So ensure that you have the correct ingredients that are required when you're baking. Another thing, don't over mix the butter. So just mix your butter up to the level required. Sometimes actually the recipe will tell you like the texture or how your butter should look like. Don't over mix, because when you over mix, you will get different results. Your cake is likely to sink. So another thing, don't walk away from certain items. For example, when you're making like a caramel, you should actually be there to monitor the how it's progressing and to ensure it doesn't burn. The moment that you walk away from your caramel when you're making it, you find it's likely to be to melt. So in some steps, ensure that you're always there to ensure that you do what is required. Another thing, do not open the oven door. So when you put your cake in the oven, before the time is over, for example, you're told to bake your cake up to 45 minutes. So ensure the 45 minutes are over before you open that door. Because the moment you open, like after 20 minutes, your cake is likely to sink. So ensure that you don't open your oven door before your cake is done. Another thing, don't forget to check the redness of your cake with a knife or a skewer. Sometimes people assume, I was told to bake this cake for 45 minutes. So 45 minutes are over, my cake is done. That is not always the case. So always check your cake with either a skewer or a knife to check its readiness. If it's not ready, you take it back to the oven. Another point that I didn't mention in do, ensure that you use the correct size of the baking tin. So for example, if you're asked to use 8 inches, don't use 6 inches, because when you use 6 inches or you use, you're told to use 1 kg, the cake that bakes 1 kg of a cake, you use 0.5 kg, it will not come out well. Or at home, you're using a cooking pan, that is, you don't know the size or the number of inches. So don't, ensure you always use a bigger, at least your butter should be half your baking tin. Your butter should be half your baking tin, it's not be full or 3/4. When you find that it is 3/4, when it rises, it's likely to pour out or it's likely to sink. So ensure you always use the correct size of baking tin that is required. So those are simply the do's and the don'ts that you should observe while baking. Actually, this I'm going to put it in comprehensive notes very soon in my blog, so keep it locked and keep in checking for details. And another thing, ensure you subscribe to my YouTube channel. Ensure you press that like button if you have enjoyed what I've done here. So all these, actually, these are some of the steps that I've followed in my cakes. You see, in all the cakes that I've baked, like the vanilla cake that I baked, I followed these various steps. You will see how I've done it, and my cakes always comes out well. So if you have been baking and your cakes have not been coming out as well, so these, now you understand some of the mistakes that you've done. So for these and many more, please keep it locked. Like our Facebook page, follow us on Instagram, Building Us Delicacies, and don't forget to subscribe.